Hello everyone, and welcome back to Sousa Plays. Time for some more Nurgle with our team, who is missing one of their dwarves still. Black Pony is on vacation, and we can't afford to replace him right around now, since Pestigors cost 80,000. So we're going to have to play another game with three Pestigors, no Ball Carrier to speak of. And Ball Carrying will have to be whoever's closest. Probably a Rotter, since the other guys are kind of useful in other ways. But maybe we can pull through with the support of our Killer, our three Claw Warriors, and our Blodge Warrior. And of course, the Lamb, with his grab and stand firm and guard. Bloat, someone would call him, but we call him the Lamb. Anyway, we are going to go right into this and try to find an opponent. And once we do, I will see you back. And we've found ourselves some dwarves. Ferdok Facebreakers. Well, if they want to break their faces, we will happily oblige. Let's see. We're looking at a Death Roller. Drink beer, party hard, play Blood Bowl. So, German sounding names. The multi-block Death Roller. You don't start with Death, he's picked guard and multi-block. Pylon on the Blitzers. Multi-block Pylon, one of them has Blodge as well. And extra movement, meaning he's as fast as any dwarf with 6 movement. The runner is kind of lonely. He doesn't have any skills and there's no other runners, so he's definitely a weakness. One Mighty Blow, 4 guards. Guard Natural Slayer, Mighty Blow. This one has Blodge Jump Up, but also only 4 movements. Is that anything else? No. Well, 1 Code Assistant, 1 Cheerleader, and finally 14-6-6. Respectable, I guess. I think our record might be a little bit better if you stack up the win percentages. He's gonna pick an Apothecary, not a Bribe. Even though he has a Death Roller. That's respect for our claws there. Don't want to lose anybody. So if we can score quick and get rid of the Death Roller, that's nice. But of course we don't really have a way to score quick since we don't have a Ball Carrier. And not that much better speed than dwarves. Slightly better. There's a weather dome, so it's our stadium. You can really see it. That's zoomed out well. Road there. Maybe that's why he doesn't have a bribe. He would probably have a bribe on his own stadium. Most Death Roller teams pick bribe as their stadium amusement. He gets to choose, so we don't need to worry. He starts on offense, because that means the Death Roller stays on the field longer. So our play here is to injure permanently, or get enough. Oh. Injure permanently, or otherwise incapacitate 2 dwarves, so he has to put the Death Roller. Wait, that doesn't matter at all. The Death Roller's on the field and he doesn't have a bribe. If he had a bribe, that would matter. Right. Do we want our beast on the Death Roller? I don't think I'd mind. Stand firm. Good armor. No pylon, right? No. So let's spread up at least, so only one of them is on the Death Roller. And let's... let's not have the beast on the line. There's no reason. A Rotter does the job. Who do we want on the front? Probably not our dodge guy, since... well, who's arguably more valuable? The Blodge without Claw Mighty Blow, or the guys who have Claw Mighty Blow? In this matchup, I think the Blodge guy is less valuable, so I'm gonna put him on the front. And I'm also gonna put this guy in the front. And claw here, claw there, This guy without guard, actually, he should probably be on the front. Keep our heptivores strong. Okay, that took a long time for not moving any players, really. Sorry about that. And how many guard are we looking at? One, two... There was four... Four Longbeards. Death Roller and one of these. The Blitzers don't have guard. They have pylon. So they're probably gonna hit these Rotters. I have to guess. Sixth guard against our... four. We have some strength to compensate for that. Could try to get a claw hit on Death Roller. It's always a dream to injure a Death Roller. Perfect defense though, that's not bad. Although he did stack the line quite... thoroughly. Ball's gonna end up next to his Death Roller. So having our beast over here isn't the greatest, even though we could Dauntless Blitz the beast. That's not the worst. We could put all our guard guys up here, but he still has outguarded. I don't think we want to give him that. I do think we want to do this, though. Put some guys out here. Bring such things like the killer because of this side. But other than that, maybe get some guys up here so he can't follow. So our guys will... Death Roller will probably follow. We'll try this. Maybe we can get a hit on the Death Roller next time. Alright. Enough movement. Wall's free. Can reach it. Takes the hits first. Could maybe have moved that Rotter to like over here or something. Maybe tied someone up. There's the hits on the beast, but it costs him some dwarves to the wrong side. That's not a turnover. That's what the dwarves call a successful block. The other teams call a 1 in 9 failure. Means a stun and then a dwarf on top, and it's a knockout. We do have the option to foul, of course. This would be a nice guy to push into the field with a friendly. Dauntless on the beast gets a push. We will. Let's not use Stand Firm. I mean, he's still getting a 2-die with Dauntless, but at least it brings him further away from the ball. And if he fails Dauntless, it could be a 1-die. He re-rolled it, even though he would still have had a 1-die. Okay, enough of that. Let's... He can get 1-dies on us. I don't think he'd take them. I'll Stand Firm. We do need some assistance on him if he's to be able to do anything. Gets a push that way, I'll Stand Firm again to deny him movement from this dwarf. And he can't hit anyone. Actually, he can. He can hit us with a 1-die. Aw. I'll still Stand Firm. Don't be knocked out. Good. That means we can bring this guy in and stand him up, and we will have four dwarfs with no real ability to do anything. Shorthands makes him get ball, and Death Roll did nothing. Unfortunately, he did block off our Surf. So what do we do? I mean, I almost tried to stand up the beast. Let's do this, and then stand the beast up. That means these guys are not going to have an easy time. One die on the beast, maybe. Could send a couple of guys in here to tie up three dwarves. Who do we blitz? Going out here seems risky. Also, the value of those targets aren't great. Can't really blitz the Death Roller. could blitz over here, but it's the wrong side, really. That's not a bad blitz, though. Let's bring these guys over. Let's have these guys in reserve. He stays back. You get hit if he does that. I'll not do anything with him until I see what this does. I have to follow if I want to add on, which I do. Bribe, so we... Him fouling us is not very likely, although it could happen. He goes there, he stands up, he hits me. I don't, he stands up, he fouls me, he still has two die here, doesn't have guard there. I think we're okay doing this. Comes up. Chooses base. We can go into the middle. Hopefully, we can take a lot of one dice, but we have blocks, so some of them should mean we get claw mighty low hits in return. We're blitzing with. Ooh, failure on the foul appearance. Do you spend one of your two rerolls for that? No. It does have guard though. But it's an assist on him. Only one counter assist. We have a two die here. Another fail appearance. Foul appearance. And one die is successful. But no breaks. We can just stand back up. We can have a one die here. A follow up one die. But he doesn't have tackle and we have blodge. Pushing him off would be kind of valuable though, so I wouldn't be surprised if he tries that. Is this is a one die. Or this is a one die. That's a one die as well. Gets it, but only gets a block. One more try. Doesn't really do anything except to spare him from one hit. This one would prevent us from getting the beast back up if he gets a push here. I'm trying to dodge. Without having dodge. 50%er. Not bad. Let's try to stand Mr. Beast back up. I could get in here, which would allow him to be hit with a blitz. Well, I can still hit him with a blitz. I don't have jump up. Get up here to get an assist. This is a one. This is a two. Get that two. I have a two here. Hit by the death roller. We could blitz out here. We get an assist. Can I surf him? I need a one die to move this guy out of the way so I get the angle. So if I moved someone here and here, I could get him. What's more valuable? We'll stand him up, he'll get punched. Take a one die on him for a push, get the surf. In that case he's not hitting. I should take these first then. They're all two dies now. Maybe I should have followed that. He's dead. Do you save a level 2 lineman? You do? And he's still there. Might as well follow. I'm getting hit by the death roll anyway. And I tried to get a one die here. Push or better, please. Yes. So you're gonna stand up, and then I'm gonna do this. Do you dodge? You do. Fair enough. Dodge again, please. No, we got him. I think that was worth a reroll. You can't let him get away with dodging on the sideline against the surf attempt and not get surfed. I think we're pretty safe from a counter surf there. Our killer might take a hit here. Our killer should take a hit here. We have guard next to him. So, but he, if he brings someone else in here, it's going to be a hit. Rotter took a punch. It wasn't. Didn't pile on. Gives us another surf. What happened there? He knocked down another warrior. I was typing. Fine, he knocked down both the warriors. I guess definitely did one of them. Foul back here, maybe. Let's see. Dodge away from tentacles. Didn't work. Try it again. No. So we could... do that, which I feel is in our best interest. He gets hit by death roll if he stands up. Can we prevent that? Not really. We could try to dodge him. 50%. If... this guy came in here, this guy came in here... we could have... oh, we can't really do that. We have to dodge this guy. Dodge this Rotter to surf another Nurgle Warrior. Or his Blitzer here. Which is not a Nurgle Warrior. I think that's worthwhile, actually. So in that case... probably we don't want this guy tagging anyone. Same here. I'll leave him on the ground while I do this other stuff. Sadly, that's a push. Beast hit. It's a dodge. Let's keep those two guys occupied. I can now come in here. Have a 2 die. Do I get the dodge? No, I don't. I get this guy. Good. 3's up our killer. No, I think we keep him on the ground. So, if this works, I will pursue the Blitz, or the surf. So I need an assist here to counter his assist. I need someone here, and that might as well be you. And you, I don't think I need, so I'll put you over here. And then I'll go this way. Get 2 down first. No, we don't want to knock you down. We want you out of the stadium. Goodbye. And this is why you want the frenzy guy. and come back here. Could attack the ball carrier, but there's a small chance of his counter surf, so I don't want that. Surf's hasn't really done any good though. We did not run on it. The roller comes up. Gets a plus two here. It should be easy with Dauntless. Even if Dauntless fails, it's enough. Didn't reroll Dauntless, just to show. Now though, he needs Dauntless and gets it. Still only a push. And now he's next to the killer. Hello there. Pushes away the Rotter to get the guard next to it. So we have a guard next to it too. So do you hit the armor 9 target with your pylon, or do you with your claw? Or do you hit... fail on the tentacles rolls on the blitz. So no blitz. He tries to hit us, and that's foul appearance. You can't get away from him, you can't punch him. What do you do? Beast's having a good game so far. Claw hit on the death roller as well. How many assists can we get for that? 4. We need 3 to make it 1 die. Which would make it doable. We have 3 guys here. We don't really have 3 spaces though. This guy stands up. He's no longer on the death roller. Tying up him is good. This is a freebie. I think we want to take this one. Sadly just a push, but I'll be fine with him being here and I having the sideline. So we can't go this way. These guys need to get back in the middle. Either way. Putting him there isn't the worst. It's better than him being out here, I think. We need to punch him first. We can't do that because we don't have guard on anyone else. We need to do this. It's the only way we can get 2 guys out of this. Maybe I needed that to assist. We'll see. Broke armor. Stuns we pile on. Getting guards out of the game is great. We pile on, even though we already used Mighty Blow, it can't be worse than a stun. Good. Reward. So now we can punch this guy. We need to knock him down to be able to hit the death roller, unfortunately. One assist. I don't think we do that. I think we just push him. So we could either activate the beast, attack the ball carrier, or blitz the ball carrier. We still take a 2 die up on the death roller, which isn't the worst idea, now that he's already tagged. We blitz this guy. We don't really have a good blitz target, so I think we just go for the ball carry with the blitz. This is so he can't dauntless his way back on us. Come around this way. Try the blitz before I hit the death roller. Got it. Hangnail 3 with the effective play. Pick it up. Sure. Good boy. Now run. Run. In dwarf terms, this guy is a sprinter. And we don't do anything with the beast, of course. And we didn't get him. Not worth a reroll. So he just gets to stand firm on us. That's okay, if we score he's gone anyway. So that's why I'm running here. Maybe I should have even made the GFI. But I kind of wanted to do this. Just a 25% chance of... multi-block! We've just seen multi-block we use effectively. If anyone's gonna do it, it's a death roller with 7 strength. I forgot about that. He's not even going to try to stop us. Instead he's going to try to take 1 dice on the beast to compensate for the death roller being gone. gets him. He has pylon, right? So don't use that. That means he's further away from this if he decides to follow us to pylon. He doesn't, because he wants to get back here. Otherwise, if this had been an armor break, he would probably have wanted to pile on. So now we need to dodge our way with this rotter, which is not super easy. Dauntless is anyway, but it's not enough. And he's already used the reroll? He used the reroll. Something I missed. Let me check. The foul appearance, the beast, and we rolled it. Okay, didn't even notice. So, we can actually hit this guy. Can free ourselves with a single push. We need someone to move up here. Can you get up there? No. You could not get up there. You could get up there with one GFI. Everybody's off your back. Oh, I went stupid even though I brought someone in there. So we're gonna have to dodge anyway. Do we really attempt this then? I will take the claw hits on dwarves here. Even unskilled dwarves like this one. Because we know the death roll is going to be off. We know there's one guy who's dead. I think that means he's going to have less than 11 players now. And that's, of course, in our best interest. Absolute bestest of interests. In common. Or going. Whichever you prefer. Don't go for it though. Bring my guys up here. Even if we fail this dodge, he's gonna have a tough time. Question is, do we do this in order to save ourselves a dodge? It's better than a dodge. But we still need a knockdown for it to be useful. I think we try it. Okay, good. Now, what's the best angle here? I think it's this. Lovely. No, what sort of idiocy is that? I was gonna push myself forward. So I didn't have to make this GFI. Well, I deserve to fail this GFI. I don't think I deserve to fail it twice, though. And he's not feeling very well about it either, but he got the score. No rotter back, no dwarves back, and the lovely sound of the referee sending the death roller off will mean the dwarves have 3 turns to score on us. 9 players, since one of them didn't wake up. Enough guard. We got rid of half of the guard actually, so they only have 3 left. But I think we still put our beast off the line here. He did a good job there. He doesn't deserve to be reduced to line duty. And yeah. I'm so set in my way to push both opponents off my players, instead of thinking that I can use the push to push my player off the opponent's player. That would have been a much better play there, which would have made up for the fact that we made a GFI to make it happen, because we took away a GFI to make it happen in the end. But we got away with it. this time. Oh, there we go. Injury on D-Elk, which I believe was fired in a recent game. We have rats. No, wait, that can't be it. We haven't played any rats recently. I can't remember any time we played rats recently. You got rolled good for DK on the first guy. Alright, so we have a bunch of dwarves on the line. This one seems most valuable. Let's put our beast on the guard guy so they can't reach position. And let's give him a guard guy next to him so he can't. Get out of there. We want to spend all our guys up here. Since you don't have dodge, I put you on the edge. We want to blitz him, preferably in such a way that he doesn't get away from us, but I think that ship has sailed now. I'll keep this guy behind just in case he needs to take care of whatever these guys do. He needs to really hustle to score though. We can catch him much later with our... strip ball doesn't work on him, so maybe we just want to use our frenzy. I'll keep our frenzy back here. He needs to get up to here to be able to score, and if he does, we should have a good chance at him. So this is 4, 5, 6. One more assist would actually make the leader. No, because then I'd have to hit from there. And then he would have an assist. So, I guess we send this guy up this way. Could shift over to this side, but he can't. He has to go forward and then end up on our line anyway. Let's try to get this speedy guy with all his stats. I think we can afford to reroll a good hit like that at this point. Maybe I didn't want to. I wanted to push him there, I remember that. He's dead though. That's good then. Doesn't really matter which square he is in when he's dead. Yet another apothecary? dead again. Alright, buy an extra apothecary, roll dead twice, have no apothecaries left. Well, that happens and he only gets pushes. Could have pushed us away from the ball, but doesn't really matter, he's not going to score, probably. It happens with all inducements, I guess, they can be super useless. Then we give him a 2-die. He gives him a 1-die, which is enough. Jornak der Schlager gets us down. I think that means the hitter. Jornak the hitter, or beater, or something like that. Schädelknacker, I don't know. In German isn't. Feuerauge. Feuer is fire, right? Fire beard, maybe. Oh, his beard's in red, so maybe his fire is something else. We have a hit on the ball carrier. Can we make it a decent hit? We can make it a 1 die. We can make it a 2. We need someone to score, so let's get this guy 6 away from the end zone. Now, whatever happens here, as long as we can get a shot at the ball next time, we can score. I want to hit here. Maybe I should first get this guy in to brawl. I just want to get in there now. Can I? I can do one GFI to get a 2 die on the ball. I think that's the best plan here. Bring this guy in here, where he ties up a guard. I want to punch this guard, which is an even better chance of doing something good. Have a reroll for it. And we will take... Look at this. I'll chain push this guy here. Will that actually help me? Bring another guard on the ball, that's not really smart. Chain push this guy away. Put him there, I could chain push this guy there. That still only brings more assists over. What if I... I don't think it's a smart idea. Let's actually do this first. Follow. We don't have guard, so it's really no point. I don't know what this... what purpose this fills. We're gonna pile on another guard dwarf. Getting rid of the guard dwarf. We don't need to. So don't pile on. And we're gonna try the beast. The 3 die. Oh, sadly. Who said he has had a good half? Not me. Forgot to press M turn. Only 4 dwarves out though. He could still have... That was our guard guy. What's this gonna be? It's gonna be a 1 die. Splinters failed. Still got the pow. Still got the arm break. Still got the kill. And we're not recovering from that. Well, that's the way your lodge guys goes. Too dead. Lodge guy. He didn't have tackle, did he? No. Lodge guy dead against no tackle, no dauntless. Charge where it hits. Oh, at least we don't have to roll an apothecary to kill him. We can kill him anyway. Oh, there's another dead player. Well, this one is gonna die the embarrassing way of being. And a skull, for good measure. Can we score from here? Yes. How do we score from here? Do we even want to score, or do we want to kill dwarves? I want to kill dwarves. Could have a mighty blow hit, and then a claw follow up. And we could claw here. If we wanted to score, we would probably want to get one of these dwarves off the ball. Probably means we start here. Grab. I mean, he doesn't do any harm here. That means we can move this guy. But we can't move him there reasonably. Kinda want to blitz with him. Yeah, I could do this. I can blitz here. Maybe even scatter the ball. Let's see. Do we scatter the ball? There are three good spots, two intermediate spots, and two bad spots that still leaves the same problem. So I think we try it. We don't want to follow because we want to assist the bat. He's stunned. Ball goes bad way, sadly. Worst way. Well, it could have been even worse. Could have landed in his hands. Let's see if we can get this dodge guy out of the way. Our tackler. It seems to be a pylon unless it's a knockout. Stun. What do we say about stuns? I guess we have to take him. That's not what we say about stuns. So we're gonna have to try to pick up in one tackle zone and perhaps even pass in the same amount of tackle zones. First, let's see if there's more dwarf armor willing to break. Wasting a lot of high rolls here that I could have used for a pickup and pass. And no damage to dwarfs. We have enough to dodge and pass, I guess. But we don't have anything else, so let's just try to pick up. Failure rerolled into success. So, two guys dead on each team. We get our knockout back. How about his knockouts? This is pretty important. One out of two. Can't complain. That means there are five dwarves out, three dwarves removed. Still three guards on the field. We get the ball. That's kind of big though. One pylon guy gone. Is that right? Yes, he died. An unfortunate death. But where are our players? Well, it's mostly the Rotters. All the unskilled Rotters have gone out, and unfortunately one of the Warriors. And no, we have another unskilled Rotter. There we go. Okay, so we want to blitz perhaps this guy. Moving the guard is pretty okay. We want to claw all the guys on the line. All of them. Once. The other way though, please. Because I want to hit the guy. With guard. More than once, if I get the chance. And if I put the beast here, at least he gets the chance to hit him twice. He blitzes. Don't really have to be there. I'll put a rotter in front of him in case they get a blitz. Doubtful that we get a chance to surf anyone, so I'll let him handle the ball carrying. Better than a guy with wrestle. Even though in this matchup it's actually, yeah, since he has block, it's better, but he's as good as, oh, come on. And we can go one back, I guess. Hope it bounces out though. Do we get anything else by moving? We can get some more movement here, I suppose. Not that we're likely to use it, we're likely to follow, and then we'd have to dodge to use it anyway. And I don't think we need to send anyone back. We can keep up with the dwarves if they try to chase it. It doesn't go out. So, risky business of picking up the ball. We're gonna wait with that. We're going to start by punching the guard dwarf. No result. Can't really afford to reroll it. I mean, get one shot on all of these, so I might as well take him from this side. He goes down. Freed him up. Unless let's gamble on this three die being successful. By successful, I mean at least a push, yes? right to grab, but it doesn't matter. We want to be there anyway, so he might as well be there. Makes it a little bit harder for him to slot the partitions around the beast. Like so. And then we take away a dodge. Gonna have to follow that. For reasons. Oh, well, we didn't need to follow. So I'm gonna try to dodge him, actually. I don't want him next to someone that might blow. Only a badly hurt. And then we fail the dodge. Worth. He could foul him. We get a chance to pick the ball up. I don't think that's worth it. Maybe I should have moved this rotter here first. Yeah, moving the rotter could have been useful, even though I didn't need the assist. Looks like he's not fouling him. He's going for the ball. Can't knock me down. I stand corrected. Use the reroll for that. Knockdown and pylon. Also in the air. Wolf has landed. Didn't break armor. Double one, actually. That should get yourself injured on a pylon. That's a way to nerf pylon that I can get behind. If you roll a double one on the pylon, you take an injury roll yourself. But you should be able to hurt yourself when you do that. Ooh, foul appearance. He has another chance, though. For a one die, gets the knockdown. I think I'll stand firm here. Because if this is not an armor break, he stands back up and every dwarf is on him. Which I like. Stand up. Okay. Shouldn't count my standing beast before they roll their roll. Then we could push people away from him. We could do that, push him there. So I should hit this guy first, but I'd knock him off the beast. I guess that's not the worst. They're not very desirable targets. I did push him off the beast. Well, I can follow that. Okay, let's do some safer moves. Let's move these guys over so they can have the dice next turn. He's gonna blitz him to here, so maybe we get to hit with him. If not, he stays on the ground, I think, so we do this hit then. Fairly good. We'll follow in hope of a... It doesn't really matter at this point if we remove this dwarf or not. Should take our opportunities. I guess I've put this guy kind of in the way, so I'll put him over here. And I don't want to dodge or stand up there particularly, so I'll try this. I mean, this could fail catastrophically and the ball could land over here, so I'm gonna do my best to not fail it. Still failed. No disaster though, even though it's a bit annoying. Nuisance. Talking about the new pylon rules in the new board game edition, I believe it is. Pylon will now cost, in the official rule set, pylon will now cost a team reroll to use, because it was considered to be too strong, I believe, probably. Knocked down the beast again while I was typing, and spent a reroll on hitting another warrior, which was rewarded with a armor break. And knockout. So we are down in men now, which we should be against dwarves. This claw is not that powerful that it can handle dwarves. We need to stand up and let ourselves be counted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plus this guy. Can't forget about him. We could stand up here and not have a hit. We could blitz with him to get in a better position, but then we don't blitz him with him. We could blitz with him, but these two dwarves are not as important. So I think we actually do the other part. Blitz this guy. And get him out of the equation. This is pretty good. Then we have a hit on him as well. You might as well stand up here. Do we tag the Dauntless guy? Yeah. Get rid of this guard fella. Looks good. Should have put him on the beast maybe, but I didn't want another guardian on the beast actually. And we can still not do that because he doesn't have guard. Alright, let's try this then. He's no failure. I can't afford to reroll now, so I'm just gonna skip that. At least he's off the line. We're getting it forward. It's gonna get there. And we're gonna afford a board carrier for the next game. Of course, he's not gonna be better at board carrying than this guy is. In fact, he's gonna be worse. But at least... Let's now just block. And we should have a 2-die here. No? No, that's not 2-die. It's a 1-die. We could put guard on the beast. He only gets... Because this guy doesn't have guard, correct? This guy doesn't have guard. His only guard is here. And up here, right? No? The other guard is off. He only has one guard left. So we should be pretty safe in a position like this. He got the one die there. Stays to get an assist on the beast. And then if this works, he has a one die with Dauntless. Tag the guy with Dauntless so that even if he gets Dauntless, he can't benefit from an assist because he has a counter assist. Gets a push. If he goes there, it's the same situation, so I will stand firm, because we're in a better spot right here. We one assist, one counter assist, same as here, one assist, one counter assist, and he gets him. But we'll still stand firm, so he stays on the mark over there. Now what's this turned into? It is a one die, which he gets, okay. Not a very good half for us so far, but if he stands up we should have a pile on, and he got someone free to hit over here, which is a double skull, last reroll gone, it's a push. Not a very good hit turn for him either then. The beast is now unsupported, and he gets a turn on him as well, so push, so we don't get a hit there unless he pushes us onto Mark, which allows us to stand up here and get a hit. Stand up here, get a hit on one of these two. I think we want to blitz down here still. These are the most dangerous guys. Then who assists the beasts? I guess we do this and don't pile on. Well, we can't pile on a push anyway. Flush a lot. Are we actually going to not win this game? Can't afford a reroll on the loner. He's gonna have guys free now. Regardless of what happens here. I think I hope for a knockdown and then I don't follow. I hope this is an armor break. It takes away some of his options and some of his life. We can get a bunch of German sounding Rotters for next game and we would need them, so I don't disapprove. We will stand up here. I think we go up and mark this guy, but he's free. I One dice. I will not roll that before I've tried to pick the ball up. Okay, so where can we go? I'm just gonna go... hang on. Don't want to get in his range. Maybe I go over here? I could dodge out to hit me here. I think I'll go... here-ish. He could dodge out and reach me. But I should be able to blitz him down. I'll take a one dive with wrestle. Benefit of tying him up if it's a push. Putting him onto the beast, quotation mark. He just takes a two die on me though. So I'll stay. Frees up some of his guys, but he shouldn't be able to get to this side. Okay, okay. There are six dwarves versus seven of our team. Still. One of our warriors are going to have to be rebought and painfully leveled back up. One dice on the killer, gets a two dice on the killer. Oh, one dice on the warrior. I think he miscounted that. Maybe he has already counted this as a hit. Actually, that's only a one die. Unless these guys have a guard, and I think only this guy has a guard. We can dodge. Oh, it was a two die. Yeah, of course it's a two die. Well, now it is, because he canceled his assist, and he doesn't have guard. Pylon on our killer. And... stun. We're fine with that. Didn't foul us, but he got the two die now. Gets the knockdown. Doesn't break armor. We don't have a wizard, do we? We have a good hit on him, though. And if that works, we can move this guy up to assist the beast. And then we can use this guy for other things. We could like blitzing him, and then maybe they getting this guy in on the action. But until I've done that, I don't really want to try and move him. Let's do this first. Well, that changes the turn. So now I will just move this guy in to assist the beasts. Good. And I will instead blitz here, which will chain push this guy onto the beast. Unfortunately, it can't break armor. I will chain push this way and follow. He still has an opportunity to hit me with a one. No, not. Because the beast is already... yeah, good. And this guy's the only guard. He's isolated, which is nice. I'll do this as well, so he doesn't have any good ones. This guy could pretty easily dodge away and hit us. I don't know where to go, though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... I guess this is pretty good, but if he goes there, yeah, that's a frenzy trap then. So maybe this is the good spot. We're running out of guards ourselves here. We only have one guard on the field, except for the beasts. So two. Which is more than one. Don't have jump up here. Foul appearance saves us from a what would be a one die with Dauntless or a red die without Dauntless. He takes the red die. He has no rerolls. Beast gets a knockdown. Now we should be pretty good. We can hit him here. And then maybe jump up, hit him. Thank you. good. That should limit his movement. That limits his movement even more. That limits his movement for all eternity. Well, actually, it doesn't limit his movement, but his agility. So, I think I can take this now without worry. I should put him there, because I want to pile on, and now he's free if I fail to break armor. Which I do. Well, still, he's not going to be able to reach this far. Or reach this far. And... let's have that hit. Doesn't matter super much. I kind of wanted him to be dead. We can have this hit and push him there. And final wrestling. It means I can't get the beast up there as I wanted. But I guess we hit this guy really stupid again. Frees another guy up. Fair enough. Of course, two of ours were rotters, so it's we're still in a better spot. Although now suddenly, two dwarves are free. Three if we count the guy that's next to the beast who's not doing anything. And let's see. Stand up here, beast him, maybe move up here. Or we can move him. Beast him. I think we run anyway, we can't really get safe. Go. We need to do something about this guy. He has dodge too. I mean, that's something. I guess we could knock this guy down, ignore him, and then tag him. That could be a one way. Five. We're not gonna have a... Oh. That's pretty bad. Oh, but grab. Grab makes it better. Freeze this guy up, which is bad. But also freeze this guy up, which is good. It doesn't matter hugely, unless this is really good. And he's stunned, which is pretty good. Knockout would be even better, actually. Because now I have to do this. Do I kill him? Do I try to... If I don't, I can go 2, 3, GFI, stop him. 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's not kill him, then. Alright. You can kill someone next turn, Pelpon. Well, maybe. Depends on if we... if we have the reroll to spare and... other necessary things. Five dwarves left on the field. Tentacle dodge. Another dodge to hit us. Made the tentacles, failed the second dodge. That's all we get, I guess. Push him? Yeah. I'll do this so I get two more chances to hit him. Without blow, without tackle though. Still rolling them because I have a reroll, and only a double skull would stop me. Hitting with the beast seems bad. I guess we have a pretty good chance of a three die here. There we go. Let's get this troll slayer out of his misery. No, armor 8 doesn't break. And we did have a lot of death this episode, so that's good. Look at that, three dead dwarves. Four dead dwarves, right? Because one of them had agility. So, who gets hit? Rotter, we still have a Rotter, you're on the line. Beast, you get hit, because he only has one guard left. And Dauntless, I guess, so that's enough. Then who? You leveled up, so you're gonna get guard. We already have guard on you. We already have guard on you. Could put two guard guys up there and hope that he can't hit them. Frenzy guy, he leveled up too. Don't want to give them red pony. I mean, he has wrestle. He's pretty good. I don't have anyone to put on the line. This is far enough that no dwarf will be able to reach me, right? Okay, these three I definitely don't want up there. Actually, these three I definitely don't want up there. Is he better than one of these? They have more SPP total, I guess. They're closer to level 6. I think he's gonna have to be White Pony, even though he's pretty good. Can't afford to lose two Nurgle warriors. I know. He's better than my tackle. So it's gonna be this. Put him in the middle. No, we want the beast next to both of them. We want to goad him into killing the beast. Doesn't even look like he's taking the hits on the line. Magic Dome cancels the nice weather. Or whatever weather that was. Nice kick! It could have been useful on a more useful pot of drive. He's gonna go for the Rotter. Best chance of SPP. Pile on a Rotter. Rotterdam Ron, only surviving Rotter. Still survives. Put his guard in a strange location. Takes a one die. Guess that's good enough. At least he's safe. And a one die on the beast. Gets a knockdown. Into injury. Uh-oh. But I think it's gonna regenerate. Lose 1 point of strength. But he regenerates like a good beast. Well, that would have been a fitting end. almost a fitting end to that game. That beast. But the beast is still gonna eat up our team value. Don't you worry about that. SPP for the dwarf though. And a really fun game. Cadit der Brutale, yes. Cadit der Brutale, yes. No. Glun der Klabauter. Gun der Klabauter. Sure. And Askir de Sanfe. Sanfe, does that mean Tooth Fairy? Alright. And of course, Sore Thumb, the MVP, with his touchdown. And 8 SPP in one game, great. Unfortunately, he died. 19 versus 10. 10 armor breaks for him, 2 knockouts, 5 injuries, 2 of them were kills. That's pretty good if you're dwarves and don't have claw. They're facing armor 8 and 9. We, of course, had 19 armor breaks, 2 knockouts, 6 injuries, 3 of them kills. But we had claw on most of those, I think. I don't think there were any non-claw injuries that I remember, but fair enough. Lots of SPP for both teams. Wait, no, Hangnail was the one who scored and got 3 SPP and then died. Sore Thumb died also with his 3 SPP, now 8. Pale Pony 2 removals, Shut Eye 2 with 2 removals, Scuffle with 2 removals. What's the power of Claw, Mighty Blow? That was all 6. Claw, Mighty Blow, and all of them. 1700, about same team value. We're going to be short players though. Well, all our dead guys are in the list here, so it'll be easy for us to find them. It's Sore Thumb 3 next time and Hangnail 4 next time. But before that, it's going to be... Alright, these guys are... I'll fill the locations. So that's better. We need to get a new Nurgle warrior. I should be able to figure out what his name was, because I had the naming scheme, but that will be next time. We're also going to have a level for White Pony, probably Stand Firm, but I'm not making any promises yet. And we have enough money for only the warriors. We're not going to have a ball carrier, sorry about that. We will get one eventually. Hangnail's also going to be fired, because I'm never going to play with a 2 strength Rotter. I'd rather fire him and get a loner if we have that few players. But team's still looking okay. But when you lose a warrior, then you're really on thin ice, is to speak, because you need that warrior back before you lose another warrior. If you have only 2 warriors that are leveled, then you're basically a rookie team. Only your rookie team has 1700 team value and is going to play as established teams. So, rough times ahead, but hopefully we can pull through. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this match, and I'll see you again next time.